From its medicinal value to the golden smiles it creates, now, chocolate is almost mythical in its appeal.
Don't lose your heads. Don't get overexcited.
And so to Paul's Valley I went, seeking secrets of Oklahoma's greatest chocolatier.
Brent, welcome to Bedere Chocolates, and we're glad to have you here this morning, and I'm going to give you some of the proper attire for work in a chocolate factory, and we're ready to go.
Instantly upon entering the Bedere Fine Chocolate Factory, I learned that this was not as intimidating as Willy Wonka's. No, this isn't Grandpa Bucket's chocolate factory. The attire, the assembly line, the workers all seemed a little less dangerous than Wonka's.
What's so funny?
Even Augustus Gloop couldn't get himself into trouble following this chocolate pipeline. They even let me try my hand at creating their signature chocolate-covered chips.
There's not really a secret. It's pretty simple.
Yeah, right. And after a few broken chips and some decreased productivity, it didn't take Oompa Loompas to usher me to the end of the line.
You do it like this. Pick them up.
Make a big stack. Oh, man. What happens if you start getting all messed up and just go... Where I discovered there are indeed some similarities between great chocolate makers. Attention to detail, efficiency, and quality control. Not to mention the seriousness with which they each guard what separates them from their competition. So ultimately, I decided to give up my dream of owning the factory like Charlie Bucket and leave the finer points of fine chocolate to the professionals, sticking to the one thing I do best, putting the taste to the test.
Chocolate Whiz, the best darn guy.